Okay, last time we were together, I did tell you that we would be flying this time because I want to make sure that we get through this. So, easy parts now. Push off. These are all the pencils we've used so far. My table is just covered with painting stuff and colored pencils and everything. But anyway, I want the lamp post. I couldn't decide at first if I wanted it in silver or gold. I finally decided to grab my gold Prismacolor. It's PC because they're Prismacolor. I am still using the Premieres, that's the soft cores, and this one's number 950. I decided I want to go ahead and go with gold because it would lend itself better to the yellows, whereas silver would just not really blend with anything on the picture. And gold would also look better with a lamp if it were lit and slightly glowing. So just trying to keep the yellows together. Now I'm going to turn this so that I can get to it easier. I am not going to go in here and color each little thing different. Now, some golds are better than others. This is not my favorite gold, but I don't plan on framing this picture or anything, so I'm co okay using it on this. If it were something I was going to frame, I would probably go to a different set of Prismacolors, or not Prismacolors, but colored pencils, and grab one of the other golds. But you could even take this and do each little triangle area in a different color. You could take it and you could do the whole thing in black. That's making me wonder, do I want to do that in black so it'll really pop? All right, so changing our mind here. Grabbing my Prismacolor black. How does it go over this? Is it going okay? Yeah, it'll go right over the top. So I am going to go very sloppily over the top of this. Now, the reason I say sloppily is because I am going to put ink over the top of the black. But if you will lay down one sloppy coat of any black colored pencil, at least I've found so far that it works with any black. See, I'm not even trying to blend that, just trying to get it on there. Then it will help the ink to more saturate everything that's down on there. All right, so let me keep going here. This is just another book that I have underneath, and I have put it under there to just make the surface a little harder because I don't want to be right on my table because it is a pine table that will take indentions and leave indentions, and so then the paper gets down in there and makes weird, wonky little spots on my page. So I just put something between me and the table. Yeah, see, I'm liking that in the black. So it doesn't matter how full swing you are into a page, you can always change your mind. Something I tell my painting students very often, it's only paint, it's only canvas or canvas paper or whatever it is, we can always paint over it. Here, you can take an eraser to most things and get most of it out. Now, I might should have done the yellow glow before the black because that black's going to smear, but what I'm going to do, we're going to see if this black marker is working enough today or if I go get another one. Yeah, this one's not got enough ink left in it to do any good. So, hang on. I know I should have been prepared. I'm not. Well, I was until I started changing my mind. I will be right back. Okay, see, you didn't even miss it, me. I'm back already. I grabbed all the things. These are a few of the black markers that I just keep laying around. I use these when I'm doing a pen and ink on canvas, and I will totally wear the nub down to nothing. These are the Sharpies, and you can get fine point and ultra fine. So I use them a lot when I'm doing things. See, there's the difference in the tips. So it's good to have both on hand. You can even get two-ended markers. You know, any black marker you've got laying around. This is my favorite. I got this from Daiso. It's like a Dollar Tree for Japan. And we have three of them that are kind of local. This is actually a cartridge pen. And I paid $1.50 for the pen and one ink refill. And then I went ahead and bought two more refills, I think, for $1.50. But I love this pen because I can do lettering on it. Like whenever, let me grab something over here. Whenever I want to do lettering, you can, and this is another whole class, on all the downstrokes, you put heavy, the upstrokes light, and then the down is heavy, the up is light, down is heavy, down is heavy. Up is light. See what I'm saying? So this kind of pen is awesome. And I still need to practice a lot with this. And then if you want, you can come down and accentuate all those down strokes. And it looks pretty cool. But anyway, that's something for another time. Let's go back to this because time is ticking. So I can take this and it works kind of like a paintbrush for me, which is fine because I'm used to the paintbrush. But see how that covers? And I get outside the lines, I'm not worried about it. But with that black underneath, it just works so very easy. All right, let's flip it over. See, it's not even going through. That black is like a barrier, and it gives you more total coverage. And I feel like it leaves less streakiness in the pen or the marker when I've already done black underneath. I don't know. I feel like it just does a whole lot better for me. And these are a wax base, and this marker's going right over it. Now, it will also go over my oil-based markers. So this truly is a good marking pen for doing this type of thing because the ink just flows out so nice. Yeah, just coloring it in. But I do like that black. It almost seemed to me that it was going to get too busy if I did all the little areas in there. And that's one thing, and I've talked about this a little bit in the past, not a whole lot, but anytime you want to change something up and you want to engulf two or three little areas into one large one, do it. See, just like I engulfed all that. There we go. Now, yeah, see, that's just a little wet. So I know to just kind of stay clear of that, and I'm okay with that. Now, so we did not use the gold. That's all right. I'm good with that. Now, her hair, I do want to make her dark haired. So I did grab some browns here. Here's another one I might use. I'm not sure which all I'm going to use. I know I want to use dark umber and the espresso, and they are numbers 1099 and 947. So I'm going to start with them and not get the others mixed up. And I know her hair is going to be a little darker right up here under the edge of the umbrella because that's shaded. Now, hair is flowy, So I won't be doing the circles. I'm going to go in the direction that the hair is going. Do you see that? I'm not coloring back and forth this way. I'm not going sideways like this. We didn't come this far for anybody to take off scribbling at this point. Okay? We're all old enough to know better than that, and we're more than capable of going in the right direction. So I've just laid down some color. Okay, that was the dark umber, 947. 947 is her hair. I know that's funny, right? And 1099. All right. Now there's not a lot of difference here, but there is just a little. All it's doing is giving me a couple of shades of brown to get started with. Because, like I said, I do want her dark haired. And generally, I will lay down my dark colors first when I'm doing any kind of hair or fur, anything that's textured that I want to look more layered. Start with your dark colors. I'm not too worried about white showing through in some of these places because we are going to come back and use more color yet to give that hair a little more depth. Okay, so just get that on. Then let's grab this one. This is 941. See what we can do with it. Yeah, see, now we're getting a little lighter brown, and that's good. Let me just come down here, and I'm still keeping the directional strokes, even though I'm not going right in all those little lines of hair anymore. I'm still keeping the direction, keeping that swing where her hair is swinging out to one side. And can you see all the different layers of color in there? Do you see the difference in this side and this side? Okay. Just doing strokes. I'm going to come down in it. Now I am going to try something, so don't get ahead of me. I'm going to try with this black and we're going to see what happens. 935 is black for the pencils I'm in. Now I am going to come up here and I'm going to do little circles. This is the shadow that the umbrella is casting on her hair. And then I'll go down strokes a little. I just want it a bit darker up under here, and then lighter as it's coming out. Do you see the difference in that? Because the umbrella is casting a shadow down on her hair. Still being careful to stay out of that lamp that's black, although it should be dry by now. Okay, so doing a little bit of that, and then down strokes. Just to blend that in. And then, because I told you I wanted her dark haired, okay, do you see how that's shaded now? I am going to take ever so slightly just some loose strokes. I'm not being particular. I'm just putting strokes, going still the direction of the flow of that hair. And see, I could put this a little darker because that strand's under that strand. I could go darker here because this strand's on top of that. You know what? I'm not going to get that picky about her hair. Feel free to. It is your coloring page. I'm just thinking that not too many people are going to sit there and go, oh, that one should have been under that one. Not when it's hair, okay? There, now I've got her dark haired. And I could even, now that I've done all that, I could even go darker up here. And I think I will. Right up next to that umbrella. I've got it really dark. And then I'm going to pull it down some. Do the hair whatever color you like. We've done enough pages now, or you can go back and look at some of my old pages on YouTube. That you can figure out what colors you need if you want her blonde or anything like that. One of these days we will do a redhead. I think that would be fun. Okay, so there's that. So that worked fine. Now I do want to work on that lamplight a little bit. What is this color? I pulled this for something. Oh, that was bronze in case I needed it for the lamp. So I have two yellows here, canary and lemon. 916, and this is for the light. 916 and 915. So yeah, just do little pictures and stuff to help give you a go on what you're doing. Okay, and that's fine now. So what I'm going to do is, this one's the lighter one, so I'm going to put the darker one in first, as if there's a little glow going on here, and then get lighter as I pull it out, darker here, lighter as I pull it out. Now, if you are using crayons that are the twist-ups, this is what I was going to show y'all. You can actually take a napkin or paper towel or tissue and do this, and it should smear your color. Okay, now I'm not, you can tell there's a little bit of yellow on the edge of that, where it did still smear it some. But I'm not using twist-up crayons, so I'm just going to go ahead and fill in now with the lighter shade, just so we get that glow in there. But yeah, so if you're using twist-up crayons, that's kind of a cool little trick. Now, it does depend on what kind of paper you're using. A slicker paper lends itself better to that pulling than a flat matte paper does. So, but I know I used to do posters and stuff when I was younger, and I would use that trick and just pull the color out. And now we have chalk pastels that we can use and everything else. So I really don't use my twist up crayons often, but just letting you know that that can be done. So just start with a light pressure on it and get a little harder as you rub around. Okay, so there's that. Now, oh, I still have the planter. What color for the planter? And I really, my mind automatically goes to a wood color. You know what I'm saying? Just let's grab this and see. I don't want to use something that's already been used, but we've used so much already. I wonder if that would make it look more like it's cedar. Okay, henna, 1031. And then if I used this shade for the shadows, terracotta. So the colors. And those colors may already be out here on the table somewhere. Okay, there's 1031. And terracotta is 944, and it's right here. All right, good. So let's add these colors to our list. The planter is 944, and 1031. So I am going to go the direction of the wood. And you could have made this a brightly painted planter as easily as just making it like I am. So your call on that. Absolutely. Whatever you decide on there is going to be fine. I am going to do this entire planter this color. And I know it looks a little scribbly right now. It's because I'm going to go back and beef it up. I'm going to take care of that. And when I'm in here around the details, I'm not scribbling. I see so many pages that are just, oh, beautifully done. And then all of a sudden, at the very end, they don't know what to do for the sky, or they don't know how to do the ground. And they'll take off and just scribble and leave it. No, so you can come back even in this and smooth that all out. Remember when I was doing the tree? It looked very scribbled. But look at it now. It's several different shades, and it's got dimension and depth to it. And that's the thing you want to. You don't want to put so much time into a page and then all of a sudden just like wreck it, Ralph, and take off and go through with. Let's do these right. Okay, you know how to make the little circles. I've done it on enough pages now that you should know exactly what you're doing as far as circles. Now, this up here, I'm acting like there's a second lip on this. I could put this as green, like it's more greenery showing through, but I'm choosing to make it a second row of wood. So you decide what you want for that. I wanted my planter a little taller. So for me, it's wood. See, I'm going the direction of the wood. Now I'm taking this other color. Let's see how this looks. It should be an ever so subtle change. Now I'm doing my circles. But see, by layering the two colors, I'm getting a brand new color. So you can layer colors anytime you want. I wanted this to look more like a brick color or a cedar. So I knew I was going to blend a couple colors together. So now's when I'm taking my time and really putting my circles in here. See, I'm circling. I've just had enough practice that I can circle pretty quickly and get up to that edge. So yeah, it's going to be fine. Hope everybody had a good Thanksgiving. For my international students, I think y'all have a holiday coming up soon. Maybe it's in January that the Canadians or my South African friend Cynthia has a holiday. I don't remember, but I will be looking it up. Okay, so now do you see the difference in this and this? All right. I sure don't want to time out on this video. I wanted to finish this piece in this video. I don't like taking six, eight parts for a page. I feel like that's just too long. I feel like I might lose people. Because they're thinking, oh my gosh, I don't have that kind of time. But part of the thing is, because my videos are real time, I do not speed them up and do talk over. I've had too many people just really ask me to stay real time. I can stay real time, and then if you don't like it, you can take and jump through it and skip around. But this way, I feel like both sets of people are happy. You know, the ones that don't want it sped up, it's fixed for them. The people that wish I would speed up, you can skip around. So it's kind of the best of both worlds. I've seen so many coloring videos where the people speed it up and you can't really see any of what they're doing. And they're talking over it, and that's fine. But if I wanted to talk you through it, I would just talk you through it. And I don't. I want to show you. Now, there's no shading on this. I'm going to keep this color out because it's the lightest. It's the one I've used last. I am going to go to, I'm going to go to black. Now, I want you to be careful going to black. If you're not used to using black lightly, then I want you to go back over. See, I'm real light touch. Hold the pencil further back. You won't be able to push as hard. Maybe that'll help some of you. But if you're not used to using black and you're afraid of coming it out with it looking black, I want you to go over and use your espresso, okay? Which is the color that we used on the hair, one of the colors, and that would work just fine. Okay, I'm just going with the black because I can control it. And I want to get that dark on there without having to do five shades, five layers. I'm going under and around all these leaves. Okay, that should make them pop up just a little and make them appear closer to you than the planter actually does. Make them look like they're laying on top of the planter, not painted flat on the planter. Okay. Then this lip, I want it to be like it's chunky and sticking out. So I'm going to do some black right here. And then I'm going to have to get lighter as I come down. Okay. So darker right there, and then lighter as I come down. Then I want this to be chunky, sticking out some. So I'm going to go right above it to make a shadow, and then lighter as I go up. If you have a problem getting that going, like I said, choose that espresso instead. Now I'm going to come back with that last color I used and do a little bit of blending. Okay, just blending that out a little. Putting another layer on to kind of knock back some more of that white. And yeah, I'm going the opposite direction this time. Do you see the difference in this right here and this? That's got a lot of white in it. By going the other direction now, I'm filling in some of those little white pitted areas that are in the paper, the tooth that's down in there. Yeah, it's just getting down in there because I'm going the different direction this time. I'm trying to think how I can relate that to you with something in our everyday. And I'm kind of coming up empty. If I think of something, I'll let you know. But yeah, there's little holes of white in your paper because it's got grain or tooth to it. And see, that's really dark in there, but I'm okay with that. It's up underneath the edge and under the plant, and it just makes that plant look like it's somewhat brought to the front. So it's all good. Okay, there's that. And I think I'm happy with that. I really like her outfit. I love those colors. And I think the lamp stand turned out good. What am I looking for? Oh, the eraser. Something I am going to do, Actually, I'm going to do this last because the chalk will get down in the areas I want to do that with. Okay, do you remember our pastels? I pull these out from time to time. Hopefully this is not going to cut me off. We have a bigger card in there now and really worked at making sure that I had room. Okay, this is the one that I usually use in my blues. First thing I'm going to do is whatever color is on there, I'm going to see. I want to go lightly down here with whatever blue is left on there from last time. Okay, and there's not much, but hopefully you can see that there is some, because I don't want the concrete to be real blue, but I don't mind it being in there some. Now be careful when you're going between her little boots. If you put this blue on top of that yellow, yeah, you're gonna get green. Blue and yellow makes green. So be careful with that. Okay, so this is where the rain water is, and it's just around some. All right, and I'm just picking up a blue. I'm just making sure it's a light blue. I start close to the puddle and then work my way out. That way it's brightest and most heavily laid right there at that puddle area. Because if it's going to come out dark, I don't want to start over here where I want it faded. I want to start it right there. And I don't protect my surface a lot because it's just on this. I'm not putting shavings all over my paper like some people do. It's just not the way I do it. Okay, I'm not going all around her because that umbrella is putting the water around the outside. Okay, and she's on concrete. So, okay, that takes care of that. Now I want to do something up in here. And I'm going to use a different blue. Let's just go over to this one. It's a little bit darker. And we're going to try it. Okay, I'm going to turn you upside down, so hang on. I'm going to try it coming off the edge here. Okay, and then I'm going to run it to nothing. See how I just blended it in there? I let it come right through here and then blended it out to nothing. And I wanted to blend it to nothing because, again, the rain is not falling on her, even though it is falling on the other side of her. It's not on her directly. Now I'm wondering which one was I on. Was I on this one? If not, it's going to look different on this side. Okay. Now I'm not going to do a lot around this because I am going to add some yellow there. Okay, so down through here, as the rain is falling. I love this little brush thing. I got this off AliExpress, A-L-I.